Hey, welcome. How's it? Welcome to Mark's Tasty Tong, where we are about to slice into some tasty beef for some tasty biltong. I have four lots of drivorce that I did last night. That's going to go in this morning as well. Well, say this morning, it's already 20 past 11. Morning. Yes, it is still morning, just about. I'm just going to... Sorry for the up the nostril look. I'm going to just throw you now into the phone holder so that we can get busy. Right. Can you see the area? Of course you can. Hopefully, that's good to go. Right, need some gloves. Knives are sharpened, boards are down, containers are out. Everything's been cleaned and sterilized this morning. Spent a good couple of hours giving everything a very good clean. But this morning, needed a good going over. We got some really nice roasts today. I picked these up this last night. They've been sitting in the fridge nice and cold this morning. In fairness, I could have left them outside, it's been that cold. And would you believe me if I told you it's actually snowing as we speak? So I will happily stay in here nice and snug as a bug. Right, nice lump there. It's one of the smaller roasts today. I'm gonna keep a small container on the side for our silver skin on the side here. Because if you watched the last time I did a live session, I've been keeping these for someone who wants them as dog chews, so I do take a little bit of meat off with them. The little bits will still get thrown away. Again, we start with very loose skin. We are really just trimming off the unwanted fat. We call it unwanted fat. It's the slippery, snotty stuff. We don't want that. Didn't go live last week. Gotta give it a miss a couple of times. Otherwise you guys get bored, eh? Let's have a look. Right. Let's just carefully go between these two joints now. Again, top round, bottom round. They do have different names. And we are just splitting in between, and then I want this loose stuff off here while it's still attached, and I've got a bit of leverage. We'll take it off. There's a nice bit of fat down there, I'll keep that. Here we have a bit of sinew that gets chopped. Right. Let's catch this piece of sinew here on the side. Wind your fingers. Trying to get in between the meat and the membrane. It's a bit of sinew there, you can see. Right. I'll try not to be too pedantic today. Let's see, we've got some nice fat on here. A little bit of loose stuff down the bottom here. So let's take that off. Don't want to go too crazy. Remember, all this stuff is just wasted money now. It does get thrown away. I'm going to leave that. Some nice fat there. I'm going to leave it. Let's slice this bad boy. Let's use the saboteur. You want to make sure after you've sharpened them, after you've sharpened your knives, just make sure there's no bits of no burrs showing on the blade, bits of metal where it's sliced. Nice. Let's turn this over because the bottom's, or should I say the top, is flatter than the bottom, so you can see where I went wrong there already. Do sometimes do it like this. This has got a bit of marbling in it. Been very lucky the last few weeks getting meat with marbling. Does make for a really tasty biltong. So those of you that ordered last week and the week before would have got some. Or you've seen the post that I put up with the marbling, where I called it nice and sexy, because I think that's pretty sexy for me. As a biltong lover, of course it's sexy. Excellent. Nice and easy, that one. What I'm going to do with this one, I'm going to cut that whole fat strip off the top. Turn it over, slice it in two. There's two pieces of fatty there. Now, I've got a relatively lean, almost fillet size. You can turn your meat if it's easier to cut. Find the flattest side, get a nice surface. This is slicing like a hot knife through butter. A couple of thinner pieces there for the dry people. There's a whole lot of lean ready to rumble. So we throw the blade down. We have a sip of coffee. What's happened here? Phone is moving. Right. You know what we're going to do? We're going to do a monster, because this is the biggest one I got in here. I haven't even weighed this one, but I'm guessing a good 15 kilo easily. I'm using Irish beef again. Seems to be a very good price at the moment, so got to use what's available. Give it a quick rinse. I don't want too much water on it. Oh my god. Damn, that's a big boy. Or a big girl, who knows. This one could be a a load of trimming involved here. I'm going to use the bigger knife for this. Silverside. Just because it's a little bit stiffer and I can get in under there. Now that's a serious strip for the doggies. Let's move back to the filleting knife. Much better for trimming. Obviously the fat trimmer did not. I still haven't even sold it. I was going to try and get some of my money back. I got all brand new blades for it and everything. There's a lot of congealed blood on the side here. We get rid of all of that. It's no good for Biltong. And on this bottom round, while it's still attached, let's just trim up the side. Give you a bit more, be a bit more sturdy, so to speak. It's just easier to trim. Hope you've all had a good week. Earned a few quid, a few dollars, pesos, shillings. There's no shillings anyway. Obviously, this pandemic is affecting a lot of businesses, homes, families, people's jobs. I was going to keep that piece, but it's terrible. Right, so I'm going to split this now. And what you do, what you're trying to do, is go where the join is, just run your blade pretty gently down. And once you got it off, get rid of the stuff you don't want on there. I've only got four roasts. Not many this week, because I did a few last week. Did a load the week before. Still got quite a bit of stock. I've got chili bites. I did all last week. Original bites. Like I said, there's a big load of Drivorce going in this weekend as well. Today. 40 kilos, so I'll have roughly 20 kilos out on Monday evening. Right, now we've trimmed that bit off, let's get this piece of sinew here. Do you know what, I might actually keep that one for the dogs as well. It's going to be unsalted. For the dogs, that is. So here on this one now, we've got a lot of loose skin. All this is no good to me. It's very soft. So we're getting quite a bit of lean out of this. As you can see, very soft and gooey. No good for Biltong. That's a nice in there. But what I'm trying to do is just take that very, very top layer off, very thin. Just put your blade in underneath. Use the fat to your advantage. We have got some nice fat here. I cut it off with meat. Going to get dried up just like that. Some congealed blood over here that will get cut out, although it will dry, it's not going to be pretty. I pride myself in quality, so I want it perfect. You guys know me by now. I get quite anal about the whole thing. Like, pedantic is the word. That's some very, very thin stuff there. I might just leave that anyway. That's not gonna, that'll dry to nothing. Bit slippery here. Let's get it off. Bit of fatty here on the side. I take it off with some meat. It's gonna dry up. Let's just take that little bit off there. Only because I don't really need it. I'm trying to think the best way to do this one now. It's quite a big piece. So there you can see the grain is going sort of right to left, and here we have the grain running straight. And what I will be doing is cutting along the grain here, along the grain, along the grain. The saboteur is so sharp. It has to be my favorite knife. Now we just want to straighten this up. If you do get a piece like that, it's fine. The hook will go through it and go into the machine. Now you can see the transition between the grains. Yeah, that going that way and this one going the other way. It's fine. When it's dried and sliced, it's going to be just as tasty. This is some really nice quality lean biltong. I'll have some good lean this week. Haven't had a lot of good lean. Oh, Siri. Oh, Alexa. I didn't even say her name and she's telling me she doesn't know that one. Alexa, play 90s mix from Amazon.
90s music, playing now on Amazon Music.
Bit of thunderstruck. I like it. No doubt the video will be paused at this stage. Not paused. See now that? I think it's scar tissue. See it there? It tells me this, there was an accident, had an accident or something. It still dries, it still eats, it still tastes fine. Alexa, volume 6. If the volume is too loud, they are surely going to block my video. In many countries. Every time I put up one on YouTube, I get a notification that my video is blocked in blah 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 country because of the music. So what you've just witnessed is me slicing a load of this lean. I keep turning it, you'll notice, just so that I can get the flattest surface. I'm not too worried about the width of my sticks or anything like that because I haven't got customers coming in and choosing sticks like they do in Africa. So they don't have to look pretty. What's happened there? Wasn't sliced through. That'll do. See this? To me, that's a bit thick there, so I'm just going to cut that down. I end up with two thin strips. So here we don't have a lot of nice fat on the top. Let's just use the big blade and let's just take that bit of fat off. See? Now, I'm almost not even, I can almost push my blade and slice through this. It's that sharp. But I'm going to be careful, doing it towards myself again, like an idiot. Right, that'll do. There's little bits on there, but that's fine. So, trying to hold it upright, going in and cutting deep. given myself a nice flat bottom now. Now we've got a nice long piece. Look now. See how this is all now with the grain. Pretty much like a tree. That last one might be a bit thick. That's okay. Be a wettish piece. Nice lean built on this, hardly any fat in there at all. The odd little speck, but it's going to be some beautiful lean built on for someone. I do, believe it or not, get a lot of people wanting lean from me. Right, another sip of coffee. Ah, it's good. Oh, that was good. Oh my gosh, there's another monster. And this one has some good fat on it. We don't want that knife, we want fillet knife. Like I said, I only got four. Four big roasts. One more after this one. Wowee. Now, before I put this the other way around, I'm gonna put it this way around so that you can see. Look at the nice hard fat on there. This is nice solid fat. That's the stuff we want. See this stuff here? That's the loose stuff. The skirt, as I call it. We cut the skirt off. Not too, yeah. That's all pretty good. I like it. I like it a lot. Make sure there's nothing on there. Right, let's turn this around. Oh, where's my other? See here, we got this snotty stuff. It's gotta go. It's gotta go. Always say it. We'll always say it. Probably say the same thing every time. So, what do we got here? You see on top of this, there it is. You want gross, that's gross. That's pretty snarly, man. That's pretty sick. Charming. Right. I'm going to use the big blade again. Just purely because of the stiffness. And I'm going to try and get right in underneath there. Because I'm keeping these, as I explained before. They'll be dog chews. The dogs absolutely love them. Absolutely love them. Might keep that piece too. It's a nice bigger piece. Gonna try and keep as many pieces as I can. You're only getting one real strip of. See, there's nice fat there. I'm keeping that. A bit of tendon stuck in here. If you can't get your fingers around it, just be careful. That's all I'm saying. Be careful. Right. Obviously this roast is going to be some nice fatty. So, let's keep the nice fat, shall we? Not doing too much trimming on this one. Obviously this loose stuff is going on. There's like some tendon there that's going. I leave some of that hard stuff. Okay, Let's put that on the side. There's a tendon on the side here. I don't keep that for the dogs. It's not big enough. Let's take that end piece off. Let's have a little look at the bottom. Remember my skirt at the bottom here. Let's get this loose stuff off. Got a lot of fat on here, so don't mind losing a little bit. So I don't mind leaving that. That is really nice on there. Trim that a little bit. This is nice and solid. Tell you what we do. I'm going to lie her on her back. And I'm just going to tidy this up. So what we want here is a nice... Geez, I'm running out of space in my tub. Straight lines. Try to vary the thickness. Some nice big pieces here. And some nice marbling, look at that. See, you've got a bit of everything for everybody this week. Bit of marbling and a whole lot of lean. That's got some lovely marbling there. It's not the best marbling, but it's marbling all the same. It's a little harder to cut through, purely because you've got all those fatty arteries. Imagine that's what some of us look like. Probably me after this lockdown. Yeah. Right, let me just get rid of those. Because I want to turn this over, I want to just take some off the side here. Make it a bit easier to cut. Let's move that knife. It's just getting on my nerves. It's in the way. You can see the fatty lines through there. Right, let's turn that over. Get some nice thinnish pieces from this. A couple of thick pieces at the end. See, that end piece is a little too thick. So, all I do is go in there and come out the bottom. Oh, that's just a solid piece of fat. I'm not going to dry that. That's all right. That was a little too... It is just... You can see there's no meat in that. It's just fat. Now... I believe you can boil it and get use it for stock, and it's try and get some of the fat out of it. I don't know how easy that is to do. I haven't never done it. So let's go down the side of this one. Get our nice flat bottom. Again, you're gaining some lean pieces. Well, in this case, there'll be specks of fat in there. It's going to be really tasty. They're going to be so tasty. It's unreal. I have got another one big roast in there, so I'm going to have to change the tub in a second. That is, or was, a massive couple of... roasts. Thin, medium, thick. Right, what do we got? Let's in a new tub. Let's put a load in here. Let's move this over. Move another tub over. Put a new tub in. Right, last one. See what we got. It's another nice fatty one. Another Irish, of course. All Irish today. Quick rinse off. Anything they managed to bag in with the, when they bagged it. I don't want to be sending it to you. Right, let's move that knife. What's that piece sticking there? Let's turn it around. Here we got our gooey bits on the top. Get rid of that. Not such a big silver strip on this side, so let's use this blade. Right, that's going in for the puppies. We got a strip here. Let's put that in for the puppies. Oh man, I got a tickle in my throat now. Right, let's get that top bit off. Can they go quicker now? Get this over with so I can get spicing. I've still got all that drywall to hang up. Hold on. Have a sip of coffee. Had a tickle in my throat, man. It's not good. Right. Again, we're getting rid of loose stuff. Not going to be too pedantic because this is going to be a fatty roast as well. I do want to get rid of the horrible stuff. Still, I still get rid of the very loose skin. I've said this before, you don't have to. See, we got, I didn't slice down that tendon there now. Oh man. Okay, that'll do. That will do. I'm going to turn this so that I've got easy access to this loose skin at the bottom here. It's the very loose stuff taking off. The skirt, I call it. Again. Okay, that'll do. I'm leaving the rest. You know what I'm going to do now? I'm going to use my Nego. My dad's glad it's going to get me in trouble. I think it's pronounced Nego. It's Japanese. See, this one's also got a scar there. See that? Bit of scar tissue in the meat. Nice and sharp, nice and deep. I'm holding side of the roast. Give me a bit more rigidity. Haha, said that without. So, when you get to the end, just be very careful. Can be quite soft. I have cut my hand before that way. Some years ago, actually. ended up slicing into my hand where the knife went through the meat and into my meat. Not good. Right, got a little bit of marbling in this as well. Very nice. As usual, top quality stuff just for you guys. With this one, tell you, because it's an awkward shape, I'm gonna slice the bottom off like I've done before. Gonna slice that in half. And let's just get some nice finished pieces out of this. I'm not doing stockies this week, so I will have some lean available. It's going to be, I think I'm just doing this all original today. Plenty original. So get those orders in, hey? Don't be shy. I know it's January, but all the more reason for a nice treat, hey? Why not? Treat yourself. I've still got a lockdown special on available on the Facebook page. By all means, have a look on the page. See what other specials I've had. Ask me. Still doing a special mix, which consists of pretty much 100 grams of everything. But the lockdown special is pretty good. Right, just gave that a little quick rinse off there. Get the blades into the sink. Get some hot water going. A little bit of soap. I will now get busy. Wow, got two people. Leo, don't be so tight asking for a tester. Put your money where your mouth is. Buy a tester. But yeah, if you're that desperate, Chana, send me your address and I'll send you a tester. All right, guys. I know you can't see me. Let me take you out the holder. I am going to say au revoir. I'm going to say cheers. See, you've got one person left. Have a good weekend. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Obviously, stay safe. And tune in again next time for another tasty session. Cheers.